Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. In this video we are going to review and see this delay timer with display for home automation. When you turn it, you can set the time so you can control an AC or DC load to be turned off a certain time. And also it has multiple programming, like four different programs. Let's get started with this. So this is the module here, and it has a 12 volts relay here, and the amount of current is 10 ampere rated. So either at 30 volts it's 10 ampere, at 250 volts it's 10 ampere, or 120 volts. 10 ampere multiplied by the voltage will give you the power that it can control. So in these countries with 250 volts times 10, so it will be 2500 watt. If you are in North America, if you see this at 220, it will be 1250, and so forth. And then we have three terminals here and three terminals here. The three terminals here are, this is the positive, will be connected to 12 volts. This is the ground. And the middle one is the input, or the signal that you can bring it from Arduino or from another device. There is an optocoupler that isolates this. And also we have a voltage regulator here, 5 volts. So if you connect here 12 volts, all the circuits inside will work with 5 volts. And the trigger also works with 5 volts. So even if I connect it to 12, that's also fine. Input will be triggered. So we have here three switch. With this one, you select which digit you want to change. So with this one, the blink moves from one to the other one, which I'm going to show you next. And with this one, you can change the value. Pressing this for a long time will change the program mode from program 1, program 2, 3, and so forth. And here we have three pin for the relay. The middle one is a common, and this is the normally connected. If you connect your two wires of the AC load here, it will always be connected, which we are not going to use that. We are going to use it this way, the middle one and here. When the light is on, the relay will be on, and these two terminal, the two wires that you are connected, will be connected. The width of this one is 35 millimeter. The length is 64 millimeter. And the depth of the device is determined by this relay and the pins that are sticking out, which is 19 millimeter. This module weighs 25.6 grams. So let me explain the AC bulb here. So this is a table light connected to the wall outlet, and the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these two wires here. I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. So the wiring now, the two wires that I showed you for the AC bulb, two will be connected on these two sides. Now it's disconnected, so the one that says with CK and common, the middle will not change, CK and common. So these are normally open. When the relay goes on, the light here goes on, these two wires will be connected. And then on this side, the three pin, or this is connected to 12 volts, this is connected to the ground of 12 volts, this is the trigger, which can go with the 12 volts here, so you can connect it and it will work, or maybe connect it from Arduino or from other source, doesn't matter. So the middle one is for the trigger, which receives the signal from any other device that you want to control this. This is the zero time. As soon as you trigger, or the input gets high voltage and then shuts off, then the device stays on until the time that you have set, and then it goes off. So the trigger time is very short. Here I've just put it long so you can see it. So it goes on and stays on for very short moment and then goes off. In the graph it was very short, so I just showed you so people do not confuse this with something else. So it just goes on and off, and then the time stays here. Let's go and set this. This is the time that I've shown there. That's a 7 second or 12 seconds that I showed in diagram. But here I've set this because 12 seconds is very long. We press this button and then hold it so it goes to P1. Press it again, it goes to program 2 or P2, 3, 4, and then it comes back. Once this is in P1, we can, this button will not do anything. The middle button will make that disappear. And then here we can change the second. With this button, it changed the time. So if the decimal point is here, then anything on the left side of decimal point is a second, and on the right side is the decimal point, like 7.1 of a second, if the decimal point is here. We can move the decimal point or change the value with these two. So if I press this, the decimal point disappears. Now we have 70 seconds. It's very long. Let me just show you here. So it's on. Now it goes one by one from 70, countdown to 0. Now, when I press this, it just stays on and it blinks. Now, next, it goes here and become millisecond. So second, and then that will be our 1/10 of a second. Now, if you can set it for very long period, so just push this and that disappeared. Now, with this one, you can select any digit and change it. So when I press it, this is now blinking. That's 100 second. It can be changed with this switch. Now it's 370 second. So it can go to 999 seconds. If you want to make this zero, just press this, update it until it becomes zero, and then use this to move to the next one. Now this is 70 second. If you want to make it like 5 second, and at this point make this zero, and then go here and then update it 5 second and press this, and it will disappear. So now it's 5 second. You see that this wire was removed. Even if you hold it, it will not have any effect. So you just need a trigger. After that, it stays there. It doesn't do anything because the initial trigger was important. So my hand just touched it. So that was P1. When you go to program 2, it just needs a trigger. So it just triggers, and the trigger goes down. That then you can set a time. After this time, the relay will go on. From the trigger, you can set a time that the relay will go on. So let's say you set it for 3 seconds. The trigger comes, it is off for 3 seconds and then goes on for the time that you set. So in this mode, you are setting 2 times, the delay time before it goes on and the time that it is on. Now let's set this. So press and hold this until you see P2, and then press this button. So the first value is the delay time before the relay goes on. To change it, we press this button here. The dot appears, which means this is a full second. If you want to change it to smaller than second with millisecond, just press this again, it will come here. So if I press this again, it disappears. 3 things happens. Either it's here, here, or disappears. So here, here, and disappear. After this, if I press this, it will go to the next mode, but let's change this to 5. So it's here now. And with this one, you make the blink come to 4 and then change it to 5. After this, I'm pressing this and it moves to the on mode. And the blink is here, so you can move the blink to any of those. So let's just set this to 10 seconds. Now we have to exit. So we have to press it until the dot disappears. Now with this button. So dot disappears, now it's ready. We have 5 seconds delay and 10 seconds on. So when I trigger it and leave, So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then 10 seconds on, and then it will go off. This is now program 3 or P3. P3 has off time and on time. It doesn't need any trigger. As soon as the device is on, it goes off and on and stays on and then goes off, stays off, and so forth. It's just continuously going. So you will set two times. So the off time and the on time. When you set the off time, the light on the device will be off. And when you set the on time, the light will be on. Press this button and then hold it so it goes to P1. Press it again, it goes to program 2 or P2. 3. Just press this middle button. Now this is the on time. Automatically it starts because it doesn't need any trigger. To change it, press this. And now we are in on and it stays. It allows you to change the value. But with this one, you can select the blinking, bring the blinking. So the blink comes here. And now this is the off time. Because this is off, this is the off time, so 21 seconds. If I change this, it will be 100 and something. So move this. That's so I'm gonna set it at 8 seconds, make this 0. So now it's at 8 seconds. I will press this until the light is on. When the light is on, that is the on time. So this is the on time. Now move the blinking with this. Let's say make it 5 seconds. 5.8 seconds. That's it, so 5.8, and then you see the off time, 1.2, 5.8, on, off, continues like that. P4 or program 4 is such that the trigger happens and stays on, and from the time the trigger stops, the countdown starts. So if you set it, let's say, for 6 seconds, when the trigger stops, that time can counts down until it's 0, and then the relay will go disengaged or disconnect. So have a look here. So now I'm going to P4. So now I'm in P4. Press this. So this is 14.7 with each. So let me make it smaller to change this. So now it's 147 seconds. So let me just change this to 5 seconds or 6 seconds. Now disappeared. Now look at the no dot, nothing. So now when I press this, it's on. As long as the trigger is on, it is on. The relay is on. But when I remove my hand from 6, it starts countdown towards 0. Off. Now have a look here. Again, this time I'm gonna disturb it again at the middle of countdown. I will connect it and you will see. So this is on. When I remove it, the countdown starts. But if I connect this again, the countdown it starts from the beginning. So let's say this is at 3 or 2. If I connect it again, it goes back to the set time of 6 seconds and start, and then will count down until 0 and the relay will go off. This device doesn't have any manual. They've used some kind of translation from Chinese to English, and after the description, this is what they have for this. every website, every Chinese website is using this, and it seems this has been translated with Google or some other software from Chinese. Many of the words that they are using, they don't make sense if you follow it. So I'm going to publish a manual for this one so people can download and print and use. This is a very useful module for many applications with four different programs and time setting. Definitely it can replace a lot of other devices. I recommend this if you're using it for time control devices. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also if you have any comment or question, please post it in the description below and I will try to answer and reply.